Hello students, we are going to discuss about rate of drying for continuous direct heat dryer. Direct heat dryer fall under two categories, namely whether the high temperature or low temperature prevail in the dry. First one, drying at high temperature. This figure shows that temperature profile of gas and solid in a continuous dryer. This graph plot between distance and temperature. Distance in a x-axis, temperature in a y-axis. Are you clear? Okay. For analogy, let us divide the dryer into three zones. Zone 1 is a preheating zone. Refer the figure, where the solid is heated. What about the drying here? Very little drying takes place. In zone 2, the temperature of solid remains fairly constant, that is under isothermal condition, and the surface and unbound moisture are evaporated. What is unbound moisture? Water evaporates easily with a normal moisture balance. There is no pressure of such water. Are you clear or not? Okay. So then point Q corresponding to the critical moisture content. So the capital Q is equal to critical moisture content. In zone 3, unsaturated surface drying and removal of unbound moisture takes place. What is unsaturation? Unsaturation is referred to air that contains less water vapor than possible. What is bound moisture here? Water cannot evaporate easily and there is pressure on such type of water. Are you clear on? Okay. So there is a sharp increase in the temperature of the solid. Are you clear? Zone 2 represents a major portion of the dryer, and it will be interesting to see how the gas temperature and the humidity varies in this section. Are you clear or not? Okay. So here point capital R denote the condition of air entering zone capital 2. Are you clear or not? Okay. This figure shows that temperature humidity variation in a continuous dryer. So this graph plot between gas temperature and humidity. Gas temperature in a x-axis, humidity is a y-axis. Gas temperature is denoted as Tg, humidity is denoted as capital Y. Are you clear or not? Okay. So the point capital R denote the condition of air entering zone 2. So refer the yellow color boxes here. So this figure shows that temperature profile of gas and solid in a continuous dryer. So if you want to refer this figure in a previous slide, so in this graph, capital R denote the condition of air entering zone 2. Are you clear on that? Okay. So the come to this point. So refer this figure, temperature humidity variation in a continuous dryer. When the drying takes place adiabatically without any heat loss, the variation of gas temperature and the humidity is along the adiabatic saturation line. So capital R2S1. So this is the adiabatic saturation line. The solid temperature. So the solid temperature capital A or A dash. Are you clear on that? Okay. So if you want the capital A and A dash, refer this figure in yellow colored box. So the capital A, the corresponding point capital Q, capital A dash, the corresponding point capital P. Are you clear on? Okay. So here heat losses are there, the path would be RS2. So in case the heat is added within the dryer, then the path would be RS3. The path will be RS4 if the gas temperature is kept constant and the solid temperature is equal to A4. Are you clear or not? Okay. So let us make an energy balance. The heat loss Qg by the gas is transferred partially to the solid Q and partially lost as capital Q. For a dryer, differential length d is that. Okay, so here the energy balance dQg is equal to dQ plus d capital Q. This is equation number 1. Here the heat loss Qg by the gas. So then partially to the solid dQ, d capital Q, this is the loss. So here from this expression, d small q is equal to dQg minus d capital Q. So general expression from heat transfer, Q is equal to UA into delta. So here capital U, area is here dS, this is differential section. Temperature different Tg minus Ts. So the Tg is the gas temperature, Ts is the solid temperature. This is equation number 2. So here what is the dS, rS? So the interfacial surface per cross sectional area. So this value is equal to small a into d z. Already I said d z is a differential length. Are you clear on? Okay. What is the a here? Interfacial surface per dryer volume. Are you clear? Capital U is equal to overall heat transfer coefficient. Tg is equal to gas temperature. Ts is equal to solid temperature. For this case, dS is equal to small a into dZ. After substituting this value, finally we get dQ is equal to capital U into A dZ Tg minus Ts. Are you clear on that? Okay, this is equation number 3. From above expression, capital S is equal to interfacial surface per cross-sectional area, small a is equal to interfacial surface per dryer volume, capital U is equal to overall heat transfer coefficient, Tg is equal to gas temperature, Ts is equal to solid temperature. So dS is equal to A into dZ, dZ is equal to differential length. So what is the relationship between heat flux and gas flow rate? dQ is equal to gS into Cs into dTg. This is equation number 4. So from this, Gs is equal to dry gas flow rate, Cs is equal to humid heat of gas, TTg is nothing but drop in gas temperature or change in gas temperature. So here you compare equation 3 and 4, LHS are equal. So the compare these two equations, finally we get dQ is equal to Gs into Cs into dTg is equal to capital UA Tg minus Ts into dZ. Equation number 5. So in equation 5, the heat transfer coefficient, that is capital U, is constant. So rearrange this expression, dTg divided by Tg minus Ts is equal to UA divided by Gs into Cs into dZ. This is correct. Okay. So here we are going to apply the concept of HTU into NTU. So what is the relation HTU and NTU? HTU into NTU is equal to Z. Are you clear on it? Okay. HTU is nothing but height of transfer unit. NTU is nothing but number of transfer unit multiplied by these two values equal to height of the tower. Are you clear on that? Okay, that is Z. So general expression, Z is equal to HTU into NTU. For this case, for gaseous condition, capital Z is equal to NTOG into HTOG. NTOG is nothing but number of transfer unit in gas. HTOG is nothing but height of transfer unit in gas. Are you clear on that? Okay. So here the differential value. Why? Because the temperatures are change in temperature. So that's why dTg by Tg minus Ts, that is equal to differential of NTOG. So the NTOG is nothing but delta Tg divided by delta Tm. Delta Tm is nothing but logarithmic of average temperature difference from gas to solid. this delta Tm is equal to Tg minus Tu. So this value is equal to differential of NTOG, that is number of transfer unit in gas. So general expression NTU into HTU is equal to Z means we want NTU value Z by HTU. So from this expression capital UA divided by GS into CS into DZ. So the meaning of Z into HTU. So from this expression, what is the HTOG? That is GS into CS by UA. Sorry, clear enough. Okay, DZ mean that is a simply Z value. So the finally NTOG is equal to Z into Z divided by HTOG. Are you clear enough? Okay. So here from this expression, NTOG is equal to delta Tg by delta Tm, that is equal to Z by HTOG. This is equation number 7. So here HTOG is equal to Gs into Cs by Ua. This is equation number 8. Are you clear enough? Okay. Second one, drying at low temperature. This figure shows that continuous countercurrent dryer of low temperature operation. So drying taking place at a low temperature, the preheating of solid is not a major factor. Preheating zone merge with zone 2, because zone 1 merge with zone 2. Zone 2 unbound and surface moistures are removed, and the moisture content of leaving solid reaches critical moisture content XC. Are you clear on that? Okay. So here the X1 is the initial moisture content. This is reaches critical moisture content XC. So drying at high temperature, the unsaturated surface drying and evaporation of bound moisture occur in zone 3. Are you clear? So the humidity of incoming gas increases from capital Y to YC as it leaves zone 3. Are you clear on that? Okay. So here the solid flow rate is LS, initial moisture content is X1, final moisture content is X2, gas flow rate is GS, initial humidity is Y2, final humidity is capital Y1. So here the solid is entering in one direction, gas is entering in opposite direction, the flow is the counter flow fashion. So here in zone 2, X1 to XC, so the zone 3, Y2 to YC. Are you clear on that? Okay. Retention time can be calculated using rate of drying. Refer the green color box. This equation taken from rate of drying part. So the videos are available in Moodle. Refer that video in the part of rate of drying. So this equation taken from rate of drying concept. The T is equal to integration of 0 to T. dt is equal to ls by a integration of x2 to x1 dx by capital A. Come to the point, the retention time T is equal to, we have two zones, T2 plus T3. Are you clear on that? Okay, this is equation number 1. So the compare with rate of drying expression, T is equal to ls by a, the second zone and third zone, integration of x3 to x1 dx by n, plus integration of x2 to xc dx by n. This is equation number 2. So from this expression, capital A by ls is a specific exposed drying surface. So the first we are considering zone 2. In this zone, surface moisture or unbound moistures are removed. For in this zone, capital X is greater than xc, the rate of drying are constant. So the rate of drying capital N is equal to nc. NC is nothing but constant rate of drying. C represents constant. Are you clear on that? Okay. So what is the general expression? Capital N is directly proportional to change in humidity. So the refer the yellow color box. The capital N is directly proportional to change in humidity. So remove the directly proportional. We are adding the constant, that is mass transfer coefficient. So the capital N is equal to Ky into delta 1. Are you clear on that? Okay. So here, then zone 2, surface moisture or unbounded moistures are removed. For this condition, change in humidities are capital Ys minus Y. So for this case, the rate of drying capital N is equal to ky into ys minus 1. So we are going to substitute capital N value in general expression. In zone 2, what is the expression? T2 is equal to ls by a integration of x to x1 dx by capital N ky into ys minus 1. So this is the equation number 3.
Thank you for your attention.